Hello and welcome to Paint Shop Pro Basics episode 39, the Background Eraser Tool. Now the Background Eraser Tool primarily is used to, get this, erase backgrounds. But what is a background? If you think about it, a background is nothing more than something that's behind the foreground. Kind of an abstract concept, don't you think? How would my brush even know what's the background? Well, okay. That's where we get into the technical side of things and tell you that the background eraser tool is nothing more than a smart color eraser. It erases a specific color. Now, if we select our background eraser tool, which is right down here, it's this eraser that looks like it's going around an object and erasing the background. You'll see a whole mess of options on this toolbar. I mean, look at this stuff. It's just humongous. This is where we're going to start. In order to erase a color, PaintShop Pro must first know what color to erase. That is handled by the sampling option. Sampling, if you click on the box here, has four options. Once, continuous, back swatch, and for swatch. Now, three of them deal with getting only one color. The other one deals with getting lots of colors. Imagine what one's the best one to use for erasing backgrounds. Wink, wink. Okay, so the for swatch uses your material palette's foreground color as the color to erase from your picture, which is really nice if you know exactly what color is in your picture and what color you want to erase. You know, that's great. But rarely, especially when you're dealing with actual photos, will you have any sort of one-color system. In fact, if your image is saved as a JPEG, JPEG, it's going to have what are known as photographic artifacts, or blocks of color, that while we can't see them, usually, the brush can, and it's going to start messing up. So never assume that you're going to have just one solid color unless you absolutely know you're going to have one solid color. The back swatch uses your background color from the materials palette. Fairly simple. The next two, once and continuous, actually sample from the brush itself. And I'll show you that. Come down here. The center of the brush, where that little eraser icon is your sample point. This is constantly looking at the color that it's on and using that color as the color that you're going to erase. When your sampling is set to once, it's only going to sample one time per click. When your sampling is set to continuous, it constantly updates what color it's looking at. Now, if you remember from any of my past tutorials, usually when you're dealing with a tool that will allow you to select a specific color to edit, you have a tolerance setting. Well, guess what? You have a tolerance setting. This brush does allow you to set a tolerance level for that color. In this case, tolerance is grayed out. That's because of this option way over here called auto tolerance. This is the preferred setup. Usually your factory defaults for this brush are good for most images. Not all images, but for most images. Auto tolerance tells you that PaintShop Pro is going to look at all of the colors underneath your brush, and through some sort of magical algorithm that the programmers at Corel have come up with, will determine what tolerance setting your brush should have as it goes over the different colors. This is preferred. Now, this is not going to give you the best results, but you know what? It's not definitely not going to let you have the worst results either. It's best to leave auto tolerance on at all times, especially if you're going to do continuous sampling, which, by the way, is the recommended sampling. So what I've done here is I'm going to give you a quick demonstration of erasing the background. I've put a red layer underneath our image, And like the eraser tool, you have to be erasing on a regular raster image. You cannot erase on a background layer or any other type of layer. You have to have a raster layer. Okay, so I'm just going to click and drag along. Ooh-wee. Isn't that pretty? Now, you'll notice I'm not going into the upper areas. You know, I'm not erasing the top portion of this. And I'll tell you why. Because the background eraser tool erases color based upon both the foreground color and the color that you're sampling. So in this case, I'm using the trees and the blue background. So the blue background is getting removed because that's the sample color. The green areas are being left in because the brush is recognizing that those are different. That's what this tool is used for, to distinguish edges and make differences between objects and their colors. It's not meant to erase the whole sky. It's only meant to erase around these edges and such. And I can do single clicks. I can drag it and drop it. But you're probably noticing a really freaky problem. We've got this white halo around my trees and leaves and everything. What's that all about? Well, that has to do with a little concept known as mixing. When colors blur together, they mix together, creating a whole new color. In this case, we have green leaves and a blue background. The green and the blue come together to create a slightly different version of both colors. And because of how this brush is set up right now, it's not removing that color. You can't remove the blue from a mixed blue and green. It's very hard to do so. Luckily, PaintShop Pro does have an unmixing option for this brush. Now you might think, oh, that's the hardness setting, right? Because it's a soft edge. No! We do not use the hardness setting. In fact, if you can, never put the hardness below 100.